Glutathione, the master antioxidant and its multifaceted roles in health. Glutathione is a unique molecule made up of three amino acids, glutamine, cysteine, and glycine. It is called the master antioxidant because it is so important for protecting cells from damage and keeping them healthy. Glutathione does a lot of different things in the body besides being an antioxidant, which makes it an interesting subject to study. We will talk about the structure, biosynthesis, methods of action, and different health roles of glutathione in this video. Structure and making biomatter. Glutathione, which is also written as GSH, reduced form, or GSSG, oxidized form, is made up of a cysteine residue linked to a glycine residue and another cysteine residue. Glutathione's antioxidative qualities depend on the sulfur atom inside the cysteine residues. This atom can easily give up electrons to neutralize harmful free radicals and oxidative species. The biosynthesis of glutathione mostly takes place inside cells, mostly in the liver. There are two steps that involve enzymes. In the first step, gamma-glutamylcysteine is made with the help of gamma-glutamylcysteine synthetase. In the second step, glutathione synthase helps gamma-glutamylcysteine add glycine, which makes the glutathione molecule whole. The amino acids cysteine, glutamine, and glycine are needed for this process to work, because they are important for keeping glutathione levels in the body at a healthy level. How antioxidants work. As an antioxidant, glutathione's main job is to keep cells healthy. It protects against oxidative damage first. Oxidative stress happens when the body makes too many reactive oxygen species, ROS, like superoxide anion, hydrogen peroxide, and hydroxyl radicals, and can't get rid of them all. Glutathione fights reactive stress in a number of ways, including 1. Scavenging free radicals. Glutathione is a powerful free radical scavenger that makes ROS safe by giving them electrons. 2. Revitalization of other antioxidants. Glutathione can rebuild antioxidants like vitamins C and E, which makes them more effective at fighting free radicals. 3. Clearing the body. It is very important for getting rid of dangerous chemicals like drugs, pollutants, and carcinogens from the body, because it makes it easier for them to combine and leave the body. 4. Protection of DNA. Glutathione helps keep DNA safe from oxidative harm, which lowers the chance of mutations and the growth of cancer. What they do for health. Glutathione does many other things for human health besides being an antioxidant. 1. Support for the immune system. Glutathione strengthens the immune system by making immune cells work better and helping the body get rid of foreign attackers. 2. Health of your cells. Glutathione is very important for keeping cells healthy, controlling apoptosis, cell death, and making sure cells divide properly. 3. Protection for nerves. Glutathione is an important antioxidant that protects the nervous system. Low amounts of glutathione are often linked to neurodegenerative diseases, like Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. 4. Health of the lungs. By lowering inflammation in the airways and improving lung function, glutathione can help people with asthma and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, take care of their conditions. 5. Health of the skin. Glutathione is thought to lighten the skin, and some people use it to make themselves look better. But people are still arguing about how well and safely it works in this way. 6. Getting older and living longer. Some studies show that keeping glutathione levels at their best may help people live longer, by protecting cells and tissues from toxic damage. Glutathione, also known as the master antioxidant, is an important chemical in the body that helps keep us healthy in many ways. It is still being studied in both science and medicine, because it can fight oxidative stress, help the immune system, protect cells, and take part in many other bodily functions. Figuring out what role glutathione plays in health and illness is important for making treatments work better and boosting general health. Glutathione may be the key to solving many health problems and making people live longer. So researchers are still looking into ways to raise glutathione levels through food, vitamins, and drugs. How do I get glutathione? What kinds of foods have glutathione in them? Glutathione can be found in food, over-the-counter vitamins, or by encouraging the body to make it naturally. Here are a few ways to get more glutathione or raise your levels. 1. Food sources. Fruits and vegetables. A lot of fruits and vegetables have glutathione or chemicals that help make it. Avocados, spinach, okra, asparagus, and squash are some of the best places to get it. Getting a lot of these things in your diet can help your glutathione levels. Foods high in protein. Foods that are high in cysteine, an amino acid that is a key building block of glutathione, can help the body make more of it. Lean meats, fish, eggs, and dairy goods are all examples. Onions and garlic. These foods contain sulfur molecules that can help your body make more glutathione. 2. These are supplements. Glutathione supplements. You can take glutathione supplements in a number of different ways, such as by swallowing pills, putting sprays under your tongue, or getting injections into your veins. Oral glutathione supplements, on the other hand, may not work as well, because the body may have trouble getting intact glutathione. N-acetylcysteine, NAC, NAC is a building block for glutathione, and is often taken as a vitamin to help the body make more of it. The body can take it in more easily. Selenium, you can take selenium as a vitamin. It is a mineral that helps glutathione work. 3. Do some exercise. Regular exercise, especially brisk exercise, has been shown to raise the body's glutathione levels. Glutathione is made more easily when you exercise, and it can help protect cells from reactive stress. 4. Staying away from toxins. Limiting your exposure to chemicals, toxins, and pollution in the environment can help keep your glutathione levels high, since glutathione is a key part of cleansing. 5. Diet that is balanced. Making sure you eat a healthy, well-balanced food is important for helping your body make glutathione. Make sure you get enough minerals, zinc and selenium, vitamins, especially B vitamins, and amino acids, cysteine, glutamine, and glycine. 6. Interventions in medicine. Healthcare professionals may give glutathione intravenously as part of a treatment plan. For some medical conditions where there is a major lack of glutathione, this often happens when someone takes too much acetaminophen or has a certain liver disease. It is important to know that oral glutathione pills may not work as well as they claim to, because the digestive system can break down glutathione before it gets to the bloodstream. Increasing glutathione levels might be easier to do with NAC and other substances. Before you start taking any new supplements, you should always talk to a doctor or nurse to make sure they are safe for your health. You can get and keep your glutathione levels at their best by making healthy food choices, taking vitamins, working out, and living a generally healthy life. But it's important to find a balance and not just depend on supplements. Taking care of your health in a variety of ways is usually the best way to boost glutathione production and your overall health. How often is the best time to take glutathione? Who needs to be careful when they use? How often and how much glutathione should be taken? As a supplement depends on the person's health goals, wants, and underlying health conditions. Before you start taking glutathione supplements, you should talk to a doctor or nurse to find out the best dose and plan for your specific needs. Keep these general things in mind and be careful. 1. Dosage and how often. Glutathione supplements taken by mouth. The best amount and regularity of taking oral glutathione supplements can be very different. Amounts that are usually taken range from 250 mg to 1000 mg per day. But higher amounts are sometimes used with a doctor's advice. How often someone takes the vitamin depends on their goals and how well they respond to it. It can be used every day or a few times a week. Dosing instructions should be followed exactly as written on the supplements box or as suggested by your doctor. N-acetylcysteine, NAC. NAC is a substance that is often used because it helps the body make glutathione. Most people take between 600 and 1,800 mg of NAC every day, split up into 2 or 3 doses. Again, make sure you follow the dosage instructions on the product package or what your doctor tells you. 2. Warnings and things to think about. Variability for each individual. Glutathione pills may or may not work for everyone and are not always safe. What works for one person might not be right for someone else. How the body reacts to supplements can be affected by things like genes, underlying health problems, and diet. Health problems. People who already have certain health problems, like kidney or liver disease, or asthma should be very careful about taking glutathione supplements. Taking extra glutathione can sometimes make some health problems worse. So it's very important to talk to a doctor or nurse for personalized help. Medication side effects. Some medicines may not work well with glutathione vitamins, especially NAC. For instance, NAC might not work well with nitroglycerin. So people who are taking this drug should be closely watched when they use it. Pregnancy and nursing. It's not clear if taking glutathione supplements while pregnant or nursing is safe. People who are pregnant or nursing should talk to their doctor before taking these supplements. With allergies. Some people may be allergic or sensitive to glutathione or the chemicals that make it up. Keep an eye out for any bad reactions, and stop using it if you get allergy signs like a rash, itching, or swelling. Effects on the body. Some of the most common side effects of glutathione or NAC supplements are stomach pain, nausea, and stomach soreness. Talk to a doctor or nurse if you have serious or long-lasting side effects. Always keep in mind that glutathione supplements might be helpful, but they shouldn't be used instead of a healthy food and way of life. It's important to get all the nutrients you need from a healthy, well-balanced diet and to talk to a doctor or nurse about supplementation to make sure the vitamin is safe and works for your needs. You should also keep an eye on how you react to it and any changes in your health.